as I was looking for schools on where to go and where to pursue my master's degree in education, I was kind of looking for something more unique. Everybody knows the common themes of education, special ed, literacy. I was looking for something that was going to set me apart and also incorporate my own interests. So I found the STEM program at Hofstra, Science, Technology, Engineering, and Math. And I'm a science, math, technology kind of person, and I didn't really understand the engineering part to STEM. But now from being in the program, I realize that it's a huge mode or theme of education. By having the STEM degree on my resume, I've gotten many interviews and job opportunities just because I have those words written on my resume. Every time I'm in an interview with a principal or a superintendent, they always ask me about my program, the types of things I'm learning, what I can do with their students, different projects, and things like that. So I think that definitely sets me apart from any other job applicant in a school. I'm currently working in Copeg School District as a permanent sub, permanent building sub, and during my interview, my principal actually asked me about my STEM project, and she approached me if I could do my thesis at her school with her students. So it's definitely a very unique opportunity. I'm currently in the middle of my action research project, and I'm working on building bridges with 26 fifth grade students. The bridge design project incorporates all aspects of STEM, science, technology, engineering, and math, specifically the engineering and math portion. For their bridge designs, their specifications include at least 10 geometric shapes, which could be squares, triangles, rhombuses, anything they want, which they have learned throughout the whole project through various activities. One such activity is building toothpick structures using toothpicks and marshmallows so they can determine what the strongest structure is, such as triangles or pyramids, and that would help them build the most stable bridge. Another specification is that the bridges have to hold at least 3 textbooks of weight, which if anyone has held a textbook, you know that it's heavy. And we actually just tested the bridges last week, and my professor came in, and as she was walking around, she was so impressed that the students learned everything that I sought out to teach them, and they were excited and motivated to work. Throughout the STEM program, the main focus is having students learn independently, trying to build a desire to learn in students. And in my own classroom, or in classrooms that I've been in, children always come up to me and ask me questions, things that they can do themselves, things that they know how to do, they just want someone else to tell them the answer. And part of the STEM program is trying to instill that desire to learn and discover and understand things on their own without asking someone else. As I was in the program, all the professors were always available through email to come in and have a face-to-face meeting or even have a phone conference, which I've done many times. One such professor who I'm in very close contact with is my advisor, Eileen Simons, and she's extremely helpful and supportive of anything I decide to do in regards to my project. And in true STEM fashion, she doesn't tell me how my project should be. I kind of tell her what I'd like to do, and she helps me work out the kinks and what we could do to make it better. One class that I've taken throughout the STEM program is the Children's Engineering Design class. And if we sat for more than 5 minutes in that class throughout the whole time, I think that was a lot. We were able to move, do whatever we wanted. We had the KSB, which is the knowledge skill base chart. So we followed that to guide our learning. And we basically did it in groups or by ourselves to build, construct different things. One project was to create a game board where we can come up with any type of game, but it had to connect to one Common Core standard, which was great because it definitely showed me that this program can align to the new standards, which is very important if you're going to be a teacher in a school today. In the future, I'd like to become an assistant principal, maybe work my way up to principal in a school.